Se cayeron edificios.
Salgan.
I heard the seismic alert went off. I ran outside. Everything was moving as I was running through the stairwell and all that. And I thought that glasses were going to shatter on my face or, you know, using all kinds of stuff.
It felt quite surreal to begin with. Something, you know, like a shake. But it grew very, very quickly. Really quite frightening. Desk shaking, chairs up and down. And just as we were leaving the classroom, our outside wall collapsed. So that was really frightening, and nothing really prepares you. Obviously, you do your best to be professional and calm, but it's hard to kind of disguise your fear. And obviously, the students were incredibly frightened. So it was a real, real kind of tough task trying to remain composed.
Actually, I wasn't sure I was gonna make it. Luckily, I'm still here, and many people, thousands of people, went into the streets after this quite heavy and prolonged shaking. On an especially poignant day, this is the 32nd anniversary of one of the grimmest days in Mexico's history, when an earthquake left 10,000 people dead. I've heard reports of victims. I understand that dozens of buildings across the city collapsed, and that the rescue efforts obviously are underway to remove rubble as soon as possible to find people trapped.
I know the death count perhaps wasn't as huge as compared to other areas of Mexico, but in Mexico City I just feel like there's still so much damage and we're still finding out numbers. It's really, really frightening, and you can see on social media my Mexican friends, you know, are communicating desperately with one another, trying to find out where people are, and warning people of areas not to go because it's still not safe. We've still not felt an aftershock, which is also a worry.